Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you my latest mock, which is another Castle team inspired mock, like the Barrel Accident that I built not long ago, and I will link it down in the description below and at the end of this video if you want to check it out. But let's start to talk about this one. Here I wanted to recreate a sort of ambush. Here at the bottom we have the king and the soldier that are walking through this forest pathway. Is a very straightforward build, no very difficult techniques here, a lot of plants. We have a couple of rocks and mushrooms in blue and red over there. I try to give these two characters a sort of worried look with picking the right minifigurette. I also build a little torch for the soldier. So here they are in this awkward situation and they don't know what's coming, what's happening. At the back there, I use a lot of slopes in brown to go up to the higher level where we have these two bandits that are throwing a net down to this soldier and king down below. I think I achieve a nice action, a nice dynamic scene, even though I think pictures don't really give justice to this, but I think from camera in the video I can show you better angles and I think it will look a little bit better. So the idea is that these two characters are throwing the net down, coming out from that cave that I built. Here also I added the right minifigure heads. As I said before, there are not many difficult techniques. I only use a couple of snot techniques here at the top to create the arch of this cave. So, as I said, I'm not gonna spend much time in showing you how this is built because it's really pretty straightforward. But hopefully I managed to create a nice dynamic scene, including this one last character at the top. Let me see if I can give you a better angle. So we have a third one of these band of bandits that is jumping from the top of the cave with his arrow and his arch, and he's aiming down at the two poor king and soldier down there. Here I use again one of my favorite parts, the minifigure stand, transparent, which is very useful to create these dynamic scenes. There is also another transparent part here, which is this long transparent rod that I use to control one of the edge of the net, just to keep it in place and not make it fall down right away. It's not super noticeable, so I think it worked out pretty well. So guys, a very quick video today, not much to talk about because, as you know, I've been quite busy over these Christmas holidays. And I didn't have much time to build new and bigger mocks or tutorials. But stay tuned because soon I will be back and I will start to do building something hopefully more advanced. Thank you for watching. Ciao, ciao.